Whoever got the flag, then I'm with y'all.
Then I'm with y'all.
And Grave will lock you up, we playing football. Okay. I'm a fanatic. You see, we got the magic. Hey, yeah, my boys are savage and open challenging.
YouTube, team, keep it clean. What's going on? It's Engraven here with another video. And before we get into this video, make sure you spread positivity, man. Protect your energy. You see somebody trying to kill your vibe? Just move on. Or just give them positive vibes, man. Give them love, man. A Steelers fan on Twitter today, in my response to the Alejandro Villanueva news, I love that name, by the way, but he tried to kill the vibe. I was like, no, he tried to make it a confrontation, but I turned it into a conversation. But anyway, team, keep it clean. I love y'all, and I appreciate y'all. Keep it going. The Ravens, they are scheduled to host former Pittsburgh Steeler, Alejandro Villanueva. That is such a cool name. Imagine hearing that come through the PA. Welcoming Alejandro Villanueva. Anyway, sorry to anybody that's listening for a headphone. Anybody that's listening on your TV, probably end up breaking your speakers just now. But he is somebody that's played both sides of the tackle position. He's played interior of the offensive line as well. And with him, what he would provide would be multiple things. And I recorded this video in 4K just so we would have a clear understanding of what this could mean for the Baltimore Ravens. Now, my internet is a bit rough, so y'all probably not going to see this for a long time. But anyway, so one of the first things that I thought of that came to my mind when I saw that they were bringing him in for a visit, I thought, Orlando Brown Jr., that trade is on the way very, very soon. And it could mean that. Because you got to think about the timing of everything. Where are we right now with the whole Orlando Brown Jr. thing? Well, I thought that the deadline to trade him is the first round of the draft. By the end of the first round of the draft, if he's not traded, I don't think he's going anywhere. And really, I wouldn't be mad at that. I would actually prefer that we keep Orlando Brown Jr. and just have him at right tackle. Because I don't want to make something that's not a problem a problem. And the Ravens could probably solve it, but still. And right now, just we've been hearing about some different rumors with Orlando Brown Jr., some different teams being interested in Orlando Brown Jr., but nothing's happened yet, so we just got to wait it out and see. But the timing right now, we're about a week and a half away from the draft. Now would be the time, anytime between now and draft night, the first night of the draft, would be the time to trade Orlando Brown Jr. So you can get that additional draft pick. I almost said comp pick. Ravens just so ingrained in my mind. I almost said comp pick. But you can get that additional draft pick. Or draft picks, actually. Because Orlando Brown Jr., he ain't going to just command one draft pick. It's going to be multiple. So it will be a first and some change. And Ravens, they could even, depending on what that first is, they could even possibly give up some back-end draft picks. But we'll see how everything works itself out. If it does work itself out. And I know so many of us are just ready for the draft. I know I'm ready for it. All the speculation and wondering who the Ravens are going to get, who this team and that team is going to get. I'm ready to just be done with it. I'm ready for the draft so we can just get through it. But anyway, this is why I love y'all and y'all are much smarter than me. Shout out to my guy, Cole Jackson, who we had on the show a few weeks ago. Maybe it was about a month ago. He brought up something that I didn't even think of. Because, you know, us Ravens fans, we can be very, very crazy. Very, very crazy. I can be crazy. Y'all can be crazy. We can be crazy. And we can think of a lot of crazy stuff. A lot of crazy stuff can be our initial reaction when we see certain news. And not that the Orlando Brown Jr. trade scenario is a crazy, a crazy reaction, thinking that this potential signing of this visit could mean something for that, because it could, but another logical standpoint was brought out. And I know I've seen some other Ravens fans bring out the same point, and it is a great, great, great point. What my guy Cole Jackson said, because he was the first one that I saw say it, he said, well, this visit could also be an indication of where Ronnie Stanley is in his rehab process. This could be an indication that the Ravens could be looking for sort of an insurance policy for Ronnie Stanley just in case he's not ready to go. And that's something a lot of times that when it comes to our offensive line situation, it's something a lot of times that I don't think about. But it's something that we have to think about. Because, and this is another reason why you just, I think my guy Sonny brought this up. But this is another reason why keeping Orlando Brown Jr. would be great. Because what if, hopefully this isn't the scenario, but what if, what would happen if the Ravens traded Orlando Brown Jr. and then Ronnie Stanley wasn't ready to go at the beginning of the season? Now, we expect him to be ready to go, but what if? You got to think about these things. We got to think about these things as fans, but even more importantly, the front office has to think about those things. Well, would you put yourself in a situation where Orlando Brown Jr. is traded? You got the draft picks now. Oh, nice. But then Ronnie Stanley, he's not ready to go. So what do you do? What do you do? This is why you got to have an insurance policy. This is why it's important to have plan A, plan B, plan C, plan D. You got to have backup plans. Just in case that plan A, it doesn't go through. So it's just that is something that is very concerning. So that it could mean that as well. But right now, again, it's just a visit. And we'll see where this thing takes the Ravens. I am very glad that they're doing this. There's some options out there at the tackle positions. Because even if Orlando Brown Jr. doesn't get traded, again, you could bring him in. It's some other guys out there too. But you could bring them in as potential insurance policies. Also, another thing too, if they do sign him, you know, hey, for them Ravens-Steelers games, if he does play, he will be blocking, like, throughout the regular season, he'll be blocking like that. Yeah. Okay, I'm trying to protect Lamar Jackson. Da, 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 da. But for them Steelers games, he's going to be going like that, looking like E. Honda, man. You know it's coming. So, we'll see what goes down. Team Keep It Clean, I love y'all so much. I appreciate y'all so much. Let's go out and have a great day. I see this guy, he's trying to sue Lamar Jackson for Lamar Jackson using photos of himself. So this guy, well, I guess he's a photographer. He took pictures of Lamar Jackson in college, and Lamar Jackson used those photos. He probably made some money off of them, maybe. But now the guy is trying to sue Lamar Jackson for using Lamar Jackson's own photos. But anyway, that's a whole nother story. Team Keep It Clean, I love y'all. Appreciate you. Please tell somebody you appreciate them, and please keep spreading positivity. Don't let anybody kill your vibe today, man. Don't let anybody kill your vibe. Have a great day. I will see you all later. Ravens press conference at 11, the pre-draft press conference. You know they're going to be throwing all them smoke screens in there. So be on the lookout for that. But I will see you all there. We are out.